From a human perspective, the Earth is enormous. However, our planet pales in comparison to the scale of the universe, to a degree almost impossible to grasp. The size of the observable universe is about 3 novemdecillion times bigger than the size of the Earth. But really, how vast is the universe? Let's explore the limits of the cosmos. To put it simply, the entire universe is the entirety of entities, known and unknown, that are governed by the laws of physics and that we can interact with. We don't yet know if it is finite or infinite. As to the observable universe, it is the part of space that can be observed. It is finite, but more on this later. Since prehistory, humans have been observing the sky in the hope of finding their place and purpose in the universe. Here is what we currently know about the cosmos. We know that the Earth is only one of the planets that orbit the Sun, the star located at the center of the solar system, which contains all sorts of other celestial objects such as natural satellites and asteroids. The solar system is only one of the planetary systems that orbit Sagittarius A, the supermassive black hole located at the center of our galaxy, the Milky Way, which contains other astronomical objects such as lonely stars and small black holes. However, the Milky Way is only one of the galaxies located in the local group. This group of galaxies is located, amongst others, in the Virgo supercluster, which itself is located in a bigger supercluster of galaxies, the Laniakea supercluster. Finally, this supermassive supercluster is located, amongst others, in our observable universe, which is constantly expanding. We say our in the observable universe because the part of space that can be observed depends on the position of the observer. In our case, our position is the Earth, which in a way means we're the center of the universe. Well, our observable universe, at least. However, in all cases, the farthest an observer can see is about 46.5 billion light years. Why this particular distance? Light traveling at a constant speed, 46.5 billion light years, represents the maximum distance an object can be from a point in space for its light to surpass the rate of the universe expansion and to reach the point. Any light emanating from an object farther than this distance simply never reaches the observer. So, our observable universe is a sphere with a radius of 46.5 billion light years, and it is expanding with the universe. Unfortunately, this doesn't mean that more distant objects are observable over time, because they are pushed away at the same rate the observable universe expands. Feels bad. But how vast is the observable universe compared to the Earth? Knowing that the volume of a sphere is 4 over 3 times pi times the cube of its radius, we can divide the approximated volume of the Earth by the volume of the observable universe. We found out, without considering the deformation of space-time and other variables, that Earth represents a mere 0.3 octodecillionth percent of the observable universe. I repeat, 0.3 octodecillionth percent. That's 57 zeros after the decimal point. This number is even 3 decillion times smaller than the size of a grain of sand compared to the size of the Earth. That puts a lot of things into perspective. To recap, in our observable universe, there is a supermassive supercluster of galaxies, the Laniakea supercluster, in which there is a smaller supercluster of galaxies, the Virgo supercluster, in which there is a group of galaxies, the local group, in which there is a galaxy, the Milky Way, in which there is a planetary system, the solar system, in which there is a planet, the Earth on which we are. All of humanity's fears, hopes, and achievements, all contained within a small rock wandering in space. Thanks for watching. I put a lot of time and efforts into the production of my videos, so if you enjoyed this one, please share it with your friends and family.